Shalom. All praises to Yahweh Bashim Yahushai, Bahashir Makakwadash. Double honors unto my apostles and elders of Great Millstone, who rule well, teach well, watching over the flock. Peace, mercy, and a salutation unto the hopeful elect. Kings and priests who are out there bringing out this word in sincerity and in truth and hopes of salvation. At Yahweh Shai's return, Brother Amawan from the Great Millstone Branch, Los Angeles, and I'm back here with another in transit, going home, almost home. I believe this will be maybe number 12 or number 13, not really sure, but just real brief, you know, just real brief. Just thinking in the spirit on how this word is flooding the whole world. Everybody is finding out about this word. Everybody is secretly learning from Great Millstone. You know, whether the world want to accept it or not, we have the truth, man. Starting with our apostles, man, we have the truth. We have the unction from the Yahweh Bashim Yahushai, and we know all things. That's not through boasting or bragging. That's through works and faith, man. All right, because you will know a fruit by its a tree by its fruit, and if it's been declared to be eaten, man. And when you look at the fruit of Great Millstone, all the camps that are set up in Holland, in the different states of South America, Central America, North America, Canada, Alaska, man, you name it. Literally, you name it. There's damn near a GMS camp everywhere, man. So what does that entail you? That we're in the end. All right, because Yahweh Shai said, once this gospel is to be preached amongst all nations, then shall the end come. And we're at the end. All right, we're at the end. The signs are here. Everything that Yahweh Shai spoke about, the earthquakes, the pestilence, all right, the stresses upon nations, the uproars of the people, it's all here. Okay? It's all here unfolding in front of our eyes with this whole COVID vaccine 19 thing going on. It's furthering the prophecies more, man. Okay, because Esau's bringing this thing down. It's here. The devil rule, as the scriptures say, he's gonna come down with great wrath because he know he got a short time. So he's trying to enslave humanity. He wants everybody vaccinated. If you want to go out and fly, you gotta have a vaccination passport. If you want your kids to go back to school, you gotta have this vaccination. All right, so Esau is moving fast because he know that he got a short time. He sees the man of the Lord on the street corners proclaiming his downfall. All right, as the scriptures say in Wisdom of Solomon, and then shall a righteous man stand in great boldness against the face of them that have afflicted him. And that's what Esau is seeing. As the scriptures say in Revelations, great fear fell on them when they saw us, man. These the least tremble when they see us, when we out there prophesying, bringing out these scriptures, all right? They tremble at that. Although to the world we may look non-sufficient, like we ain't worth nothing, we ain't about shit, coming from the ghettos and all this, how we look and how we dress, judging the outward appearance, not knowing that we are the Lord's servants. We are the chosen people of Yahshua. This devil has downtrodden us as a nation, man. You know, spoken bad about us. You know, took our heritage from us, put us into slavery, man. Now this is all coming back on his bitch ass, man. You know, it's all coming back to haunt this man. You know, you can't hide from your crime, Esau. The scriptures say, the shame of thy brethren, the shame that you brought upon you, the shame of Esau, what you have done to Jacob, is gonna cover you, man. And it's covering you, devils, man. You could try to take what you did to us out of the history books. You know, you could try to take it out of your school curriculums, take it out of the minds of the people, but it's embedded in Israel's mind. It's in our heart. The damage is done. So now all we waiting for is our recompense. Yahweh Shai being sent to gather us from the land of our captivity, and that's it. All right, because we in those times, man. The Lord is going to beam us up, certain of us, Akyan. Some of us is going to be martyrs on the side and be in those ships when Yahweh Shai returns. But this is it. We in the end. We in the end. We in the end of the book, man. All right. We the time of the vision is at hand. The days are not being prolonged no more. The Lord is speeding this thing up, man. If you're not seeing it, if you're not in the spirit, that's because you still in this American dream. You still believing that America is going to bounce back. All right, everything is going to get back to same. Not knowing that the Lord's servants that are teaching are here in the end of the world, man, prophesying. All right, in sackcloth. All right, being defamed. All right, well, we're going to get fame at. We're going to get fame. The Lord is going to put us up on a pedestal, right? Because he ain't forgot us, right? The Lord said he's not unrighteous to forget our work of love and labor that we have showed toward his name, man. So the Lord sees everything. He sees what you brothers and sisters is out there doing towards the work, man. He sees all that. Yahweh Shimei Al-Shai sees it all, man. As the scriptures say, his eyes is in every place, beholding the evil and the good. So Esau right now, he's on borrowed time, man. All right, his time is at an end, and we're at those times, man. Just look at the way this presidential election, the divided states of America, everybody wants to move out of California because of the taxes are so high, right? Move to Texas, move to Arizona, you know, move to different states, because this shit is going up, man. Everybody is not on one accord here, okay? They see the lockdowns getting worse over here, so they move to another state. Like what's going on in Denmark right now? Those people out there, they're trying to move citizenship. You know, you can't leave Denmark, or you can't fly out, go see your family or whatever, unless you have that jab and go, man. If you don't got the jab to go, you ain't flying nowhere. All right, and pretty soon it's gonna be domestic. All right, domestic traveling. All right, using your car and all that. This is where we going to. All right, you had a brother out there in Vegas bring out how it's giving you 10 years in Australia for just preaching, man. You know, so Esau is going to come down, right? Cuz he sees us, man. He sees us out there and we're the worst thing to this man's lies, man. How do you expose a lie? You tell the truth. And Esau has hidden himself with lies. His whole rulership, his whole domain was through deceit and lies. And that's what the scripture said was going to happen. He was going to come out of the caves for a time and a season, or and deceive the nations. And that's what he did. He set up himself as being the Lord, put up a white image. He put up the angels as being white, the Heavenly Father as being white. Okay. His whole tabernacle and all that just being made abominable. Facing it in the sight of the heathens, man. You know, so we're in those times, man. You know, you had that Shabazz talk about, you know, how great Millstone has it, man. And he was defending us too, man. You know, if you can't see that Great Millstone is a camp, man, then what are you, where are you looking at, man? What are you reading? Or where's you getting your understanding from? Because you got men that are of the world seeing who has the truth, man. Okay. And these men are not—they're not on the front lines. They're not out there doing what the men of Great Millstone aren't doing it, but they can see it on the outside looking in. All right, because even people that's in the world, they can recognize the real from the fake, man. Okay, and that's what you see amongst IUIC, Great Millstone, ISUPK, GOCC, all these other camps. You can see who is teaching it the right way and who is teaching it the wrong way. Okay, and you see Great Millstone teaching it the right way. They ain't no breaks out there in the winter and the cold. All right, your job tell you you got a job that works out in the cold. They tell you you got to go to work. It's mandatory. It may snow today. It may have some heavy rain, but get warm. Well, it's the same thing with us. Our apostles, hey, you still got to go out there. Find some covering, find some shade, get some umbrellas, and be instant in season and out of season. And that's what you see. The men a great millstone being in season and out of season, man. We don't matter if it's hot as hell outside, or we're born a burden of the heat of the day, man. Burden of the cold of the day. Burden of the warm of the day. You know, don't matter what time of the day, as long as it's fitable for us to teach. But all the other camps, shit, they take breaks, man. They take breaks, man. You think the Lord is looking at a servant that's taking breaks? Now just lead a sheep, just go over there. You know, I'ma attend to y'all another time. Sheep starving, you know, all of them male deficient. You know what I'm saying? And that's these other guys, man. You know, but Great Millstone, what our teachers is showing us, man, as the scriptures say, as from a child that has known the holy scriptures, that is to make you wise unto salvation But from a child, you have to have right parents. Who are our parents in the spirit? Great millstone. Our apostles, man. The men that you see that have been doing this thing for the YouTube. Before the YouTube, before I was even born, man. I was born in 93. All right, and the apostles came in, what, 85, 86? I was still in the spiritual world, man. Still in the spiritual world. But here it is. I come, you know, all of us brothers, whatever what year we were born, we had that that fashion of life. And then we was introduced to the truth. And we understood who was teaching it the right way. Coming out of the world, you recognize the real from the fake, man. Because you've been lied to your whole damn life. Now here it is, the truth coming to you, man. And everybody don't like the truth. That's the one thing about the truth. Everybody hates, the world hates the truth, man. As the scriptures say, a sinner findeth an excuse according to his will, man. You got all these camps, they want to find an excuse. Or find an excuse they want to find an excuse to bend to Israel, man, to I know it says this, like such as the rape doctrine. All right, we ain't out there doing that, but the scriptures say this is what happened in the ancient world. But let these guys read that. They're not even going to teach about it. They're not even going to go into it. They just going to brush it off. They're not even going to touch it, man. Scriptures say, eat thee the whole roll. And there was written lamentations, mournings, and woes, man. You know, this is a law, statutes, and commandments. The Lord has gave us guidance, all right, and how to do and how to be valiantly for the truth, man. But you guys are not valiant for the truth. Why? Because scriptures say, he that speaketh the truth maketh himself an enemy, man. Y'all not trying to be enemies to the world. Y'all want to be friends with the world. All right, y'all still want to get alone, man. The Lord ain't with that. The Lord is not with that. How can two walk together except there be agreed? Lord said, I didn't come to bring everybody together, but a division, man. You're going to have some that's going to believe the right way and some that's going to believe the wrong way. And that's just the truth, man. You know, but I just wanted to speak on that real quick. I seen that dude Shabazz. He talking about the chip. You know, how can you not see that, man? How can you not see these guys that are of the world can see it? But it's just the most highest movie, man. We just got to see how else it's going to roll, man. But call all your how about Shimi Aoshai by Shirma Kakwadash. Double honors unto my apostles and elders of Great Millstone. Peace, love, and salutation to the hopeful elect. Until the next one, I say Shalom.